Now, some might say, well, gosh, in the press, there have been these other sensational allegations. We've seen others that have popped up after this one. Well, I thought it was striking in yesterday's hearing that not a single Democratic member of this committee chose to ask about any of the other allegations. I think that indicates how little credibility there is behind those allegations. The one that is the most sensational, by the client of Mr. Avenatti, makes extraordinary claims, which apparently our Democratic colleagues are embarrassed to say publicly because they demonstrate that this has become a partisan circus. This is not about substance. This is about smears.
Can I ask the senator if he could sum up? The reason I've done that is because I'd like to give everybody a chance to speak.
This committee has given Dr. Ford and Judge Kavanaugh a full and fair opportunity to lay out their views. And I will say, unfortunately, the conduct of our Democratic colleagues, it's been clear that this has been all about politics, all about delaying this confirmation until after the election, hoping that they win the Senate in the election, and then keeping this Supreme Court seat vacant until 2021. Every Democratic member of this committee before the confirmation hearing started said they opposed Judge Kavanaugh before a single thing started. And not only that, this allegation, the ranking member of this committee had it in writing on July 30th. If on July 30th that had been reported to the committee chairman, this committee has a process to investigate it, a process to investigate it that is confidential, that the FBI could have participated in investigating starting back in July 30th, that we could have had a hearing that is closed, that is not dragging either of these individuals through the mud. That's the way this process should have worked. And the testimony yesterday from Dr. Ford is that the only people who had copies of the letter were herself, her lawyers, Representative Eshoo, and the ranking member of this committee. Dr. Ford further testified that neither she nor her lawyers handed the letter over. That leaves the only conclusion possible is that the letter was leaked to the public by either of the two Democratic members of Congress or their staff or someone else to whom they gave it. If there are only four people that have it and two did not give it, then the other two are the only possible sources. And that, unfortunately, demonstrates a cynicism, a willingness to smear Dr. Ford if it helps politically delay this nomination. I think we have an obligation to be fair, to be impartial, to listen to the evidence, to weigh the evidence. That's the right thing to do. And that's what I hope this committee does, and that's what I hope the full Senate does.